Hi guys. This time, the theme is how to make rotary axes. Most people who want to have your own CNC machine will eventually want to have a 5-axis CNC machine. And when it comes to machines that can machine iron and steel, that are harder than aluminum, as far as I know, there is no such desktop machine that can be bought by an individual. But I made such a 5-axis CNC machine at home. I hope my design will reference for the machines you are making. One of the hardest things I faced when designing this machine was how to design the rotary axis. I think there are three main things that are required for the rotating axis for machine hard metals. Strong holding force. Strong torque. Strong structure that can withstand machining resistance in all directions. However, none of machines with rotating axes that can be purchased by individuals meet these requirements. The main reason is that the structure uses a timing belt and a pulley. When driven by a belt, the belt always stretches, so the holding force is very low. The reduction ratio when using a pulley will be about 5 to 10 times. This is not enough to output high torque. Then what should we do? Use worm gears and worm shafts. This structure is also used in structure of real industrial machines. It meets all the requirements for a rotating shaft for machining hard metals. But there is a problem. When using worm gears and worm shafts, there is usually a clearance between them, which causes backlash. When backlash occurs, it will not be able to machine hard metals properly. In other words, it need to apply preload to the worm gear and worm shaft to eliminate backlash. Worm gears, worm shafts, bearings, etc. can be purchased easily. However, the problem is that the housing and special parts to assemble them must be made by iron or steel. But I think most people that don't have own industrial machinery at home. In my case, I started making those parts with this machine when it became possible to machine 3-axis. Some people may have doubts about the structure to be shown, such as poor machining accuracy of parts and not using large parts, because there is a background that there are only poor equipment. If you are like my background and want to machine steel metals at home but don't have the machining equipment, I recommend subscribing to this channel. This channel will be useful for you. If you support my activities, and you are thinking of making something similar, I would be grateful if you could purchase it from the parts link in the overview column. With your help, maybe I can build my own factory. It's my dream. This is the shaft of the rotary axis. Install the shaft collar to the shaft, and the worm gear. The rotary axis of this machine is not designed to rotate at high speed, but I want to make it as strong as possible. Therefore, the bearing uses strong taper bearings. A preload must be applied to use taper bearings. File these heights to adjust the amount of preload. After install this housing plate, make it feel like the four points that have been filed are slightly floating. It become the amount of the preload. There is one problem. When the worm shaft rotates, this structure causes lateral force to be applied due to frictional resistance with the worm gear, causing the worm shaft to move. This is a countermeasure part. The lateral force is fixed with this angle parts. After installing the part, it can withstand the lateral force. We'll be right back. preload is applied to the worm gear, and there is always no gap between the worm gear and the worm shaft, so if their accuracy is poor, the worm gear housing will move back and forth, like this. This will mechanically eliminate the backlash of the worm gear. What about holding force? It doesn't seem to be a strong holding force. I have always been dissatisfied with the holding power of this A-axis. It is possible to increase the holding force by increasing the preload of the worm gear, but the resistance of the worm shaft will increase and the stepper motor will step out. In order to prevent step out, I have ordered a part as a countermeasure part this time. Increasing the preload increased the holding force of the A-axis, but it did not make a big difference as expected. However, since the gearbox was installed to the stepping motor and the torque became 6 times stronger, so I think there will be no step out in the future. How was it? Did you enjoy it? I will continue to post DIY videos about metal machining and CNC, using poor machining equipment. Next time is the C-axis. It is basically the same as the A-axis, but the C-axis was need to be miniaturized, and it was much more difficult than the A-axis such as the home switch. If you find any interest in my activities, please subscribe to this channel. Don't forget to push the like button. If you have any questions, please comment. Reply may be delayed, but so far I have replied all. See you again.